It's an awesome day to you, our lovely and smart real estate investors, both at home and also in diaspora. It's a beautiful week, and I'm so delighted seeing you and, of course, appearing on your screen today. In case you're coming across this channel for the first time, this is Property Matters. This is where we discuss everything you need to know about real estate investment here in Lagos, Nigeria. Are you looking forward to buy a landed property and you don't know the preferred location you should go for? Or perhaps you're looking for properties that could serve basically for rentals, short lets, and the likes? Or you perhaps, you know, done a lot of real estate investment that turned out not to be your expectation. You want to know more about real estate in listing, you want to know more about land documentation, property verification, intense due diligence, everything that is related to making a safe, profitable, as well as what rewarding real estate investment in Lagos, Nigeria, you are at the right place. And of course, do well to subscribe to this channel, turn on the notification bell so that when I drop a video, you will be the very person to see it. So today we're going to be talking something very, very exciting, okay? And of course, you know now, our topics are well-packed, researched, thoroughly done, just to keep you, you know, informed, so that whenever you're making a real estate decision, you will make a decision that will perhaps, you know, make you lose money. In case you're coming across the channel again, once again, just subscribe to this channel, turn on the notification bell, and please share this video. Like we said, some of the content we share here on Property Channel Matters help people not to make a terrible real estate investment. I'll be back after this video. Stay tuned. Right, I'm super delighted to be on your screen today. And of course, like I said, in case you're coming across this channel for the first time, let me tell you the work we've done. We've done a playlist on the affair. We've done a playlist of how to unravel fake lands with excision title, how to unravel a fake real estate transaction. We've done playlists on how to know or on why developers sell committed properties to people. We've done extensive playlists of affair, Ibejuleki, what is freehold, what do you need to understand about freehold, how safe is the freehold. So in case you're coming across the channel once more, subscribe to this channel, turn on the notification bell, and I can assure you that when you subscribe, you will find value. So today I'm going to be discussing something very, very intense, and of course today's topic is going to be in series. Today I'm going to be talking about land grabbing problem in Lagos, Nigeria, and what you need to understand when you are buying a land, and most times you don't even understand the history surrounding those lands. Okay, now just relax and let's go without waiting for more further time. There've been a lot of discrepancies, a lot of crises, a lot of disagreements between real estate developers and ancestral landowners. During our course of investigation, I was somewhere a few weeks ago, and I found out that a developer was having some serious arguments and issues with some landowners. And to cut a long story short, we found out that that place was heavily secured with mobile policemen, military personnel were there, trying to, you know, maintain law and order in that instances. 3 weeks later, the developer got the land and he was making plans on how to, you know, do allocation for people who have bought into that scheme. To cut the long story short, during the allocation, some ham thugs, okay, invaded that allocation, did a lot of damages, and people who escaped that scenario, I know, will forever live to tell the tale of how they narrowly escaped death in the place of trying to get allocated to the property which they paid for. Now, when we're talking about land grabbers, Now, land grabbers is a serious issue in the real estate market. And as an investor, you need to understand that the possibility of land grabbers invading your property is very high. More importantly, if the necessary due diligence has not been taken fully into consideration. Now, let me quickly reiterate this fact. Land grabbers are not always attacking, but there are some places that you need to do a thorough due diligence in order for you to find out that you are not making a terrible real estate investment. Now, when we talk about these land grabbers, it is not just a Lagos thing. It's more or less like a nationwide scenario. When you look at Edo State, when you look at Delta State, when you look at Oyo and even Ogun State, this issue is like a global phenomenon. So you need to understand how this can affect real estate development in Lagos, Nigeria. In 2021, there was a family. Now, I'm not allowed to mention family names, okay, because of their confidentiality. So there are some names I won't be mentioning online, okay, but I'll be mentioning the police so that you can understand some of the things. In 2021, there was a particular family that cried to Lagos State. Now, the family is around the Ogombo area of Abramade, Sonya. And they said that they've been currently, you know, tormented by land grabbing and a lot of things have happened. Now, a few weeks later, in Ibejulekki, okay, and when you look at Ibejulekki, now, what most people don't understand is that Ibejulekki did not start from Eleko. When you look at the geographical mapping of the island, okay, the island stopped. The same island that many people are familiar with stopped at Shongotedo. Okay, so if you are going further, so Ibejulekki starts from Abijo, okay? And many of us are already familiar with what happened in the Oluwa community of Ibejulekki, which is Abijo area. Now, there have been a lot of discrepancies, and to the point that even the residents of Oluwa are accusing government of not following due process. Of course, we don't have the total information, so we won't be disclosing that. So, fast forward in 2022, April this year precisely, there was also another similar land grabbing case at Ibejulekki, and most especially the Eleko axis. Now, although government is trying everything possible in order to ensure that those people found guilty of land grabbing are made to face the full wrath of the law, I must admit that the Lagos State government, they are trying their best. And of course, according to our information, just February this year, Lagos State government have received 1,000 petitions of land grabbing related cases. Now, when you look at those people, you will now understand why you need to do a thorough due diligence when you are buying. You know, we've addressed the cases of governments taking over land because some due diligence or some papers have not been submitted. We've adequately taken care of issues that, of course, that regards, you know, excision, gazette, how people can, you know, manipulate excision and, of course, use it in selling. Now, you need to understand that whenever we're talking about obstacles that surround land investment, it's not just government. You need to look at the possibility of government playing their part, and you're also going to look at the issues of Omonile playing their part, and that is the issue of land grabbing. Now, when you look at the Shongotedo axis, these people accused some officials, although these informations have not been very clarified, so we don't know if the allegation is true or false. But they said that some government officials manipulated some things to take their land for them, and some of the structures that were built by them, some people used the influence of these so-called government officials to grab their land and take their property from them. Now, how does this affect you? I'll be doing that immediately after the break.
To to the state government, the federal government, and the people of Nigeria over unrest in their community since the 1st of September 2022. The unrest, they say, was as a result of land grabbers' activities with demolition of over 50 houses in the community. Speaking to newsmen, the monarch explained that there is a court judgment on the said land since 2009, which is already in favor of the people of the community, adding that certificate of possession as well as other legal documents are also intact.
I don't know why our government is doing like this to us in Ibejulekki, particularly Oluwa town. We are part and parcel of this Nigeria. We are part and parcel of Ibejulekki, and we are part and parcel of Lagos State. I believe where the government sends you is where it's supposed to go. But you now come to the community. What are you doing? What are you finding in the community? It's not right. So we are now telling the people of Nigeria, people of Lagos State, to please help us. We have judgment on our land.
My people are not intending to cause any trouble in their on their land. This is their land. It is those who don't have rights that will be taken off this land by the due process that is set out by the law. We are going to follow the law. We are going to insist on every inch of our land coming back to us because the judgment of the court are so pronouncing in our favor.
This thing people are doing is not good. The talks will not allow you to come in. They change us the way we cut classes, with charms, with gun. There were a lot of gunshots. I had different videos on my phone to that effect. And from the information we gathered, but that I could actually send them. With Angela Motosho, all of them, they were all involved in this demolition. So later in the evening, I saw Gabba too, was here. So from my best of knowledge, I want to believe that it was one that brought those thugs to this village. The land grabbers. So please, we beg you, Nigerian, Lagos State, everybody, please help us.
Welcome back. So I said I will be talking about how these land grabbing issues affect you as an investor. Now, I don't want you to get discouraged from making real estate investments. Over time, resources, information have proven that a profitable real estate investment is done on time and it's also done correctly. So as an investor that wants to buy property in Lagos, Nigeria, you know, I've always insisted on the source. The source in the sense that the person who is taking you to make this investment matters. Now, what most people don't understand basically is that land investment does not stop when you have been allocated. I've seen several scenarios whereby you want to build, despite the fact that you have paid all the statutory fees, all the land fees, some people will still come and meet you and will still demand that you pay some money. And in most cases, whenever all these issues and scenarios are happening, the realtor or whosoever agent that takes you to that land most times are not always available to attend to this crisis. Okay, so how does this affect you? Investment has gone beyond them allocating. Whosoever is handling your real estate transaction must be readily available to attend to any pressing issue that may arise. Because you see, the truth of the matter is, I've heard so many people talk about this land is free from Omonile Wahala. But the truth of the matter is, 75% of the land that is being sold to you as an investor is never free and may never be free from Omonile Wahala. So whenever crisis happen, our response to those crises determine if that issues will be addressed adequately or if other issues may arise. Now, I'm going to be listing how it affects you. Number one, when you buy a land in places where land grabbers are tormenting people, if you are bought with a reputable real estate developer, you don't need to be scared, okay? We have seen instances whereby top real estate developers have handled the cases of land grabbing maturely and professionally to the point that all their subscribers, okay, are not affected. In fact, there have been instances and cases whereby even some of those people that have sold to you are experiencing these land grabbing issues, they don't get to tell you. It is when it has been resolved that they tell you. Okay, so I'm going to be laying emphasis on the brand who you're buying from matters. Now, I've said it several times that a lot of real estate developer, a lot of people are also are into real estate development, not because of the fact that they want to serve. They are in this industry simply because of the fact that the industry is profitable. Now, where the brand matters basically is that some issues may arise from that property, okay? Now, if the brand you're buying from does not have the capacity, when you talk about the capacity, I'm talking about the connection. You know, anything in Nigeria is connection. Who you know matters. More importantly, when you are dealing with land grabbing related issues. Let me just let you know that. So if the developer you have bought property from is not highly connected, does not have all the necessary resources to fight this case to the end, you may end up losing that investment. So the brand you are buying from is very, very important. I must state this. In as much as fact that many people hate me saying this, telling you guys the truth, the brand you bought matters. Then number two, the agent in charge. I've seen cases whereby land grabbing issues got worse that the agent in charge ran. I've seen several issues. Of course, there are some issues. In fact, I've seen cases whereby when there's a crisis, I found out that even some of those Omonile people have guns. Yes, they have guns. Most of them are armed. So whenever there are land grabbing issues that result to crisis and stuff like that, they come out heavily armed, shooting at whosoever they found on that land. So this is where you need to deal with the right source. Okay, when it comes to real estate investment, it is not every advert that flies your screen you patronize. There are some important questions like, what is the name of the brand? What project have these people done successfully that they've delivered to people? These are questions you should ask before you buy. Now, if they say they've done this, how many people have built on those projects and how many people are not experiencing land grabbing issues? Number three, what are the legal clauses supporting my claims? What happens if these issues are repetitive? What is the financial capacity of the real estate company? If peradventure they have to go to the Supreme Court, because there's a lot of land grabbing issues that are in the Supreme Court. These are pertinent questions you must ask any realtor that tells you to buy a real estate property. I've said this before. Most of these guys are highly mobilized, well-financed to make you, financed to convince you to buy a property. And once a transaction has been done, in most cases, you don't hear from them again. So these are some of the things. Now, I'm going to continue this in subsequent series, because I don't want this video to be too long, because I don't want to bore people. But places where there have been land grabbing issues, I'm going to list them quickly before I round off today's segment of property matters. Ikorodu have experienced high return, high activities of land grabbers. Ibejulekki, that one, it can't, it's no fee end. Ibejulekki have experienced high places of land grabbers. Abidjo, some places in Abidjo. Now, when I'm, let me quickly reiterate this. Not everywhere in these places, so, but places where land grabbing cases have been, you know, recorded are those areas. Ikorodu, some places of Ikorodu, they are under intense. So if you want to do a property there, you need to ask, okay? Some places in Ebejulekki, yes, there have been cases of high land grabbing activities. When you look at the places of Shangotedo, in fact, Shangotedo, I'm going to be doing a series on land grabbing activities on Shangotedo. Just calm down, okay? Just relax. Subscribe. That's why I said you should subscribe. See, all the information you need to know, me, I will give you. Don't just subscribe. So Shangotedo, Abramadesonya, Ikota. So the island, some places of island are not even exempted. And everything I'm saying, I have written. So I'll be doing some series, you know, explaining those land grabbing activities and what the government is doing. Okay? Some places of Ikota, Aja, those Badore boys. Man, those guys, twally. When it comes to land grabbing issues, man, so you have to investigate those areas too. So we have Ikota, we have some places in Lekki Phase 1. But Lekki Phase 1 basically is more or less like an advanced place. So when land grabbing issues come, if it affects your property in that area, just be ready to spend money. So these are some of the places that if you're buying a property, I'm not saying you should not. You should do a thorough investigation. And of course, you can also contact us to help you handle the process of investigation. I was somewhere at Shangotedo yesterday, did a thorough investigation. Of course, the investigation is still on. I think I'm going to do investigation for a month before. So this is where I'm going to be drawing the curtain of today's episode of Property Matters. I hope you found value. And of course, subscribe. And of course, I'll see you in the next episode. Thank you. Have a nice day. And God bless you. Bye.